Look, the party's over. It's been a long vacation, and your fans are waiting to see you again. And you guys all know how you look in rehearsal is how you come across on stage. So let's do it one more time from the top and let's get busy.
Realest voice of guy talk show in America. This is the Doug Stewart Show. Tribute Tuesday. We got an encore performance by the great New Edition. Did it last week.
I don't love her. I try to tell myself, but you can see it in my eyes.
Yes, sir. Let's go.
So don't deny. I can't fool no one else. The truth is in the tears I cry. 'Cause if it isn't love, why do I feel this way? Why does she stay on my mind?
I swear to you, I'm doing the steps in the studio. I still remember the steps from back in the day. I'm still remembering the steps back in the day. You're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. So I quickly pulled up, and this is a Tribute Tuesday. I quickly pulled up Vick's little bio. How many years did he play for Atlanta? So he played for Atlanta 6 years. Okay, 6 years, and obviously he was in jail for 2007, 2008. So he played for the Atlanta Falcons for 6 years. In 6 years in Atlanta, and all of these stats are pretty much derived from the career highlights and awards. They're derived from his time in Atlanta. So the man went to the Pro Bowl four times. Well, he actually went in 2010. In 2010, maybe he was with the Philadelphia Eagles. So let me make sure of that. Let me verify that before I move on in this conversation. Yeah. So he actually, coming out of jail, I guess he did redeem himself, made it to a Pro Bowl as a Philadelphia Eagle in 2010. So four-time Pro Bowler, NFL Comeback Player of the Year in 2010. And if you look at his numbers, he had 133 touchdown passes and 88 interceptions. That's probably a good percentage in relative terms to other quote-unquote great quarterbacks as far as interceptions. If maybe you talk about somebody like Brett Favre, he probably has a number with way more interceptions. I know Brett Favre is the all-time leader in interceptions. He has 22,000 passing yards. I just brought up somebody else that's right around 30,000 passing yards. I can't remember who it is right now. So 22,464 passing yards, passer rating of 80.5. I'm not sure in relative terms where that ranks as far as the best. I think the best passer ratings are like 107 or something like that. And then here's the thing about it, though. He has 6,109 rushing yards. And he has 36 rushing TDs. They conveniently in media leave out those rushing yards and rushing touchdowns when you're talking about a quarterback, which I think is stupid as hell. Why would you do that? Those are numbers. That's his production. He didn't produce those numbers in the traditional way, but those numbers led to his success in being a quarterback in the NFL. So if you added in his rushing yards to his passing yards, that's damn near 30,000 yards that he accounted for. If you add his rushing TDs to his passing TDs, that's right at 200 passing or 200 touchdowns accounted for and 88 interceptions. Yeah. Mike Vick is the worst quarterback ever. Okay. Let me read some of these messages in the chat room on Spreaker.com. from Nino the Wino. My main beef with Vick was the fumbles. Dude could not hold on to the ball for ish. I agree with that. He had a problem with holding on to the ball. He had a problem with holding on to the ball. He held on to the ball like a loaf of bread. And he also didn't learn how for the life of him. Up until the last year he played for who? The Pittsburgh Steelers. This ninja could never learn how to slide. I could never understand that, man. He just couldn't learn how to get down and protect himself. From Kenia Small, Gruden was just mentioning that about a lefty quarterback on how it's so hard for them because players can't catch their passes. Yeah, but that's an excuse. What they call that back when I was coming up is an excuse. You know, how did the receivers that Steve Young threw to for when he threw for all of them cotillion million yards, how did they catch the football? You're in the NFL, you got to catch the damn football. I remember at the time when they were making that argument, and it was a lot. It was a lot of drop passes by Michael Jenkins. And remember, I pulled up the little roster at the time, like in 2006. This was when, so in 2006, the returning starting wide receivers were Michael Jenkins, Roddy White. Remember now, Atlanta people wanted to run Roddy out of town his first couple of years because he was, you know, was so much of a disappointment. You know, Roddy, I don't know, and that's why they brought in John Horn later to teach Roddy how to be a professional. So I don't know whether Roddy just wasn't putting in the time or whatever, but Roddy really struggled his first couple years when Vic was the quarterback. The Roddy White that Matt Ryan played with was infinitely better. Trust me on that, okay? And also, Brian Finneran. So Vic was throwing to Michael Jenkins, an unseasoned Roddy White, and Brian Finneran, which is a possession receiver at best. Yeah, that's truth. From Cornelia Small, not too bad they're going to get caught the minute they try to pawn a championship ring. From that boy Chucky Doug doing the routine, shawty, yeah. You know the little routine the New Edition cats they do when they have their hands up, like over their head, side by side, and then they come down like it's rainfalling, they're doing their fingers like rainfalling. I was doing that in the studio just now. You never forget those steps. You never forget those steps. Angry black man in the chat room on Spreaker.com. Ryan has been surrounded with great players around him at the skill positions his entire career. Celebrate his year, but be careful extending him for several years and giving him a truckload of money. Well, Matt Ryan's, if you're talking about the future, he's a little bit older in relative terms. How many years has Matt Ryan been in the NFL? I'm going to guess 9 or 10. I think it's 9. I think the number I remember him saying was 9 years. And this year was, in relative terms to the last three, was an aberration. You know, he threw a lot of bad interceptions. I always talk about Matt Ryan's probably more so than any other quarterback I can remember throwing more red zone interceptions than a little bit. But this year he gets credit, but it's just hard for me. I can't forget, you know, what Matt Ryan's done over the last 3 years. You shouldn't ask me to forget that, okay? He's had a fantastic year this year, but the last 3 years were horrible. And before the last 3 years, good, solid, once again, average. But not with a lot of Atlanta people. And Matt Ryan and Falcons apologists would lead you to believe how good of a player he's been. No, I'm sorry. I'm not just going to give a watered-down opinion because, you know, you like Matt Ryan or we're in Atlanta and he's the hometown guy, whatever. No, I got to keep it real. The only thing I've ever done on radio for the last 15, 16 years is keep it real. And I'm not going to change that now. I'm sorry. From Chuchi, who was the Falcons quarterback in the midst of the 80s? White dude that had a funny shaped head. you're talking about Barkowski, Steve Barkowski. I mean, Barkowski was the quarterback before Chris Chandler, I'm pretty sure, you know, and I didn't follow Falcons football that hard, that direct in the 80s or whatever. But it was Steve Barkowski was the longtime quarterback of the team before then. From 9-0 to Wino, I agree, Doug. Ryan was on the way out. Oh, yeah, they were talking about, especially in the last 3 years when he struggled and threw all these bad interceptions, I mean, there were whispers about drafting a quarterback. You know, he'd been in his eighth, ninth year, and obviously what we're doing with him isn't working. Not that he's a bad guy or he's a horrible quarterback, but maybe the Falcons might draft the quarterback, you know, early in one of the early rounds. Yeah, that was some talk out there. From Grego, from X-Squad, here goes something, you know, contrarian like I know. Tom Brady wouldn't have gotten hurt if not dirty-ass Bernard Pollard. Bastard, whatever. Yeah, Tom Brady standing in the pocket gets hurt. This whole notion about you have to be this pocket passer is just crazy. From Sandman, in 02, Vick was throwing the ball to Trevor Gaylor, Quentin McCord, Sean Jefferson, and Brian Finneran. Wait a minute. So, man, you went even further back than me. The stats, the numbers, and the names that I brought up were like in 2006. He went to jail, or he didn't play in the 2007 season, I believe. So you went back to 2002 Atlanta Falcons, and you brought up some names, sir, that I had totally forgot about, or maybe I blocked those names out of my memory totally on purpose. Trevor Gaylor, Quentin McCord, Sean Jefferson, Brian Finneran, and Willie Jackson? Child, please. Out of all of the names I just read just now, this is going to shock you when I say this, but it's true. Out of all the names that my man Sandman listed for receivers that Vic was throwing to in 2002, out of all those names, the best one was probably Brian Finneran. Trevor Gaylor? Wow. I had forgot that name even existed. Trevor Gaylor? Wow. The great Trevor Gaylor. That's funny. That is funny, man. From who we got here? Brian Hill. Vic never learned to get to the third progressions. Hell, second progression because he was exciting. Well, here's the thing about it. If you got an offensive line that's like a sieve and cats are coming through and you don't have, you know, the normal amount of time that a quarterback would have in the pocket because your offensive line is that bad and the chances that you do throw the ball to a receiver like Trevor Gaylor, he's going to drop it. Why would you wait for your third progression? And when you've been blessed with the God-given ability to run and athleticism, maybe if you was athletic as Mike Vick and your receivers were dropping balls left and right and you were relying on Trevor Gaylor and your offensive line was a sieve once again, and defensive linemen and linebackers were on your ass within 2.2 seconds as compared to the normal 4.5 seconds, maybe your ass would run two. It's all about perspective. That's all I'm saying. It's all about perspective, okay? All right? The perspective. If you're comparing Matt Ryan and Mike Vick, you got to have perspective about this. And the players that surrounded them, the team at the time. I mean, even you can talk about the coaching staff and things. I know it sounds like I'm making excuses for Vic, and to a large degree, I probably am. Because it's just ridiculous when I hear people say that he was this worst quarterback of all times. You know? It's just ridiculous. Whatever. From Sidney Jackson, Vic got hurt in 2003. The Falcons went 5-11. Three of those wins is when Vic came back in 13. That's another great point. Oh, I remember that. Man. That's right. So 2003, so I'm guessing 2002 was maybe the first year that he started. Didn't start his rookie year. Started, as he mentioned in the little article,